be unto you. To those of you who are unfamiliar with those words.
Hey yo, straight lace up at the Jill in the snatch bar. 1998 Labor Day, shopping center in Pathmark. Okay, I guess the feeling is back, huh? I threw it all away, Bob Dylan. Who the villains of trap blood? Niggas been calling me slime since 99. Fuck a Vine, with Sloopy Killer, thought you wasn't lying. I make a movie, spend a fortune on the side. Just had my cousin Buki high, run up on your car, lick off a shot. It's for my niggas with no mind, that wanna see a nigga like me pull up for the feeling real blind. I aim to please, the bow made, James was bleached. The teeth was gold, the shoes was chic. The fuck you mean? The rebel with the fashion on Z, zigzag zig, forever with the Magnum on me. Yeah, floor seats.
Right now we in Temecula, California, self-made training facility. I come out here sometime. I train in my garage. You know what I'm saying? I train for fights in my garage by myself. Only time I really go to gyms is like to spar. But I like coming down here. My man Frenchie, this is not a bad, about 45 minutes from my house. My man Frenchie, you know, he a Muay Thai guy, and they're different. I like how they, Muay Thai fighters and trainers are fucking tough, and they hit hard. If you ever watch Muay Thai, like there's a couple guys that switched over like back in the day to boxing and fucking dominated. They're fucking tough, and they can hit, you know what I'm saying? So, you know. That's why I come fuck with French. And he's a good dude. And I like fucking with good people. So that's really it.
Hey, what's going on? My name is Frank Samani. They call me Mr. French or Frenchie. I've been in this combat sports / MMA for about maybe 15 years. I started off of just trying to get in shape. Once the weight came off, I started getting a little intrigued about kickboxing and so on. I started doing kickboxing at first, and I just fell in love with it.
1, 2, 1, 2. One time. 1, 2, 3. Jab, lead hook. Bop, bop. Yep. Step. Nice again.
As far as like, I never got to compete. Getting hurt, setbacks, life happens, you know, you got to pay the bills, get a full time job, and so on and so. But one day, one of my buddies asked me to help him get ready for a fight. I was like, I'm not a coach, but I do what I can. And that was a start. That's what started clicking. People start calling me the coach, but I tell them, I'm not your coach, I'm just here to help. And I don't know, a couple years down the line, I finally embraced it. You know, I was like, okay, well, let's give it a shot. And I've been here since then after that.
I look at love as a command to just rise to your greatest potential. You know, and that's how people should feel. Their objective should be to rise to their best potential in life. If it's to lose 30 pounds, if it's to pass a test, it should be to win a fight, to be admired by people all over the world. It should allow you to rise to your greatest potential, that you look at yourself in the most grandest fashion. You know, a room without a book is like a body without a soul.
All of the tough guy shit, the mad rage, never works. You be calm. First of all, being calm is intimidating to your opponent. Like, he ain't worried.
Yeah, you're doing shots and you're just like.
You're like, you just move right. Forward. You know, and you're seeing what he got. You know, you absorb a little bit. Look, yeah. Oh, that ain't that bad. Or if it's hard, like, okay, I know I'm gonna stay on the outside.
You know what to do now.
Yeah. Let me see how he react to this. Okay, let me see. You downloading data. You know, smart guys do that. They'll sacrifice a round or two. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
The thing is, when you coach or anybody that starts with boxing, they have that body mechanics where it's left, right, left, right, left, right. So if you do a left, you're going to do a right, okay? The people that makes or that set you apart is when you're doing bop, bop, you're staying on the same side. So now you hear boom, boom, right hand, okay? You're still on that same side, so you keep them guessing. You go to that body, boom, boom, right hand. People are used to that, all the time. Okay, so if you do a right hand, I will block here, and I block here, and then eventually you go to the body, and you block. But when you come forward now, you more boom, boom, then move out. And then when you come again, nope, bow, right away.
I feel like people shit on muscle, right? But when you build a muscle and you already know how to punch, I feel like it makes you more explosive. You know, power and speed. You know what I mean? And also, sometimes the quickness is deceptive. It ain't necessarily quickness, it's timing. You make it seem quick. You know what I mean? Like, when you're throwing a 1-2 in my mind, I'm like, you know, set them up with a slow one, whatever. Get them used to that. Maybe throw a fast one here and there. Slow, parry the offense. But when I'm thinking 1-2, I'm thinking one, as this one is starting to come back, that two is coming. So that's not speed, it's timing. But it's bop, bop. It's, he just got touched. As soon as this moves, bow. It seems so fast, but it's timing.
Is there like an appreciation for guys like, I would say, Mike, that, like I was saying earlier, like, he don't have to do this. Like, he don't even have to do this to even want to do it. But the fact that he is putting in an effort, like later in his career, in his life, to pursue something, even if it's not at I'm going to be the heavyweight champion of the world, but he's doing it because he
yes.
loves it, like, that you still give your time and effort to
yes.
like that.
Oh yeah, that's this is what you look for in a person when you ask him when you're first walking, because he's made, you know what I'm saying? He has a career, he has businesses, you know, he has money, he has cars, family, you know, but he does it because he loves the sport. You know, he loves it because he wants to do it.
But that's a question people will ask. It's like, why is Mike Rashid fighting?
Why would he fight somebody that's up and coming that can have a little recognition of beating me, shutting me up? You know, somebody that's fighting to pay bills when I'm not, because I love that fucking challenge. That's a fucking challenge. They're like, oh, this young motherfucker, okay. He half my age.
He wants to push himself. He wants to be challenged. And he's willing to put in the work and the time. You know, it ain't nobody gonna, one, just come in and just start boxing for a career or trying to make it into the pro circuit, you know, especially if you haven't made it already. You know, a lot of people are like, why am I gonna get punched in the face if I already have a good income and a steady job and I'm fine where I'm at, you know? Everybody's different. You know, some people are just trained to fight because they want to fight. It's right. Not because they grew up with the fight in them.
Right.
And sometimes those are the dangerous ones also.
Yeah.
But, and then you have the other guy where he struggles and he's hungry and
right.
he wants to make it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's two type.
Right.
You know, but sometimes you have those average Joes where like, they want to fight because they want to walk around like,
yeah.
yo, I'm a pro fighter,
yeah, yeah,
I fight.
Yeah,
I'm
yeah.
a, nah, I ain't all that. You know what I'm saying?
See, my reason for fighting is I love the fight game. I started fighting when I was a kid. I stopped in my early 20s, and it fucked me up that I never turned pro. So now I'm like, fuck it, I'm gonna turn pro. And I'm just a fucking thrill seeker. I'm a risk taker. And you know, that's a chapter I want in my book before the casket drops. You know what I'm saying? Yep, pro fighter. He did it because he really fucking wanted to. I don't walk around like no fucking tough guy. You look at my videos, I talk about love, like leading out of love and shit like that. Like, that's me. My next trunks might have love on it. You know what I mean? Floral print, all that shit. Talk shit. See what happens. You know what I'm saying? No bullshit. Like, I do it because I love and respect boxing and fighting in general, like martial art. I grew up watching kung fu movies, all of that shit. I love it. Study Bushido code, all of that shit. I love it. I love it. I love it. And I love things so much, I gotta be a part of it. I can't just sit and watch, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I'm doing it.